Sat Sri Akal. Today we begin with our second introductory note. Why I say introductory? We have not yet started properly learning the language. We simply introduction, some problems of learning any language, whether it's Punjabi or any other, or and some main points, how Punjabi is distinct from other languages, how we have to concentrate on the distinct sounds which are very particular, very specific to Punjabi, which are not to, let us say, English. Now, today we will concentrate on two things. One is some patterns, some sentences where we will concentrate primarily on intonation, how the sentences are spoken. For example, last time we talked about intonation of question and answer. Now the same we will do here. I'll show how the same sentence, same utterance can be pronounced as a question or as a as an answer. We have now again the same kind of thing. See, this I generally write in what we called international phonetic script or in English. I'll write equivalent in the script of Punjabi, that is Gurmukhi. For the time being, just to show that it is different, slowly at the end of our course, we will have a proper series of 2-3 lessons where we'll present Gurmukhi script properly and with their sound system and also how it can be used. But for the time being, just to show, I mean, it looks odd, but for example, this would be say, and then it is the same thing. At the end, chahidi, chahidi, chahidi. Now the important point is these are three sentences: cha, chahidi, coffee, chahidi, koi cheez chahidi. Meaning simply, do you want tea, you want coffee, or do you want something? Now the same sentence, if I say cha, chahidi, or I can use a. See here, or without it. If I say actually without it, if I say cha chahidi, you see, if I constant, if it is a question, then it is would be like that. Do you want tea? Would you like to have a cup of tea? Then intonation will be going up. Cha chahidi. Then if you want to, I want tea. Then say cha chahidi. See, in one sense, the question mark, the intonation goes up, and the other, the intonation goes up. The same sentence can be taken as a question or as an answer, which is quite complicated because this is not possible in every language. Sometimes you will have to say, "Do you want tea? Would you like to have a cup of tea?" And they say, "Yes, please. I would like to." See, this will be answer. And here you don't have to change the sentence, and you see, I can, you say, I would like to have a cup of coffee, you say coffee chahidi, but you can say coffee chahidi. Do you want coffee? You say instead of tea or koi, or do you want something? Koi cheez chahidi. See, then you see, koi cheez means something, chahidi means do you want. Also, this is again a little introduction, and we will go slowly. See, in Punjabi, like in French, but not like in English. In English, the whether something is masculine or feminine, that depends upon physical gender. A boy is masculine, a girl is feminine. But tea or coffee, there is no gender. In English, it is the same thing. Whereas, in Punjabi, every word, every item, everything in this world, whether it is a tree or chair or blackboard or tea or coffee, it is either masculine or feminine. If you have some idea of French, in French it is the same thing. Every word is, every item is either masculine or feminine. But it must be remembered that they are not the same. See, what is masculine in Punjabi may be feminine in French or vice versa. See, for example, wall, kand. Kand is wall. Kand is feminine in Punjabi, but mur is in French. It is not. It is masculine. See, the idea here is that some genders is physically determined, and in some languages, and one of those languages is Punjabi, and another is French. The gender is not necessarily the gender. For example, to say cha, tea is feminine, or coffee is feminine, or cheese is feminine, it has nothing to do with, this gender is purely what we say, a grammatical gender. See? And then at the same time, see this ending, this is very important, the. You see, since it is feminine and it is singular, it is the, e. You see, then it will be, you see, this would coordinate, you see, this is feminine singular, this is feminine, you see, instead, for example, if I say, instead of say tea, if I want milk, for example. Instead of asking for you want tea or you would like to have tea, if you want to say that I want milk or would you like to have milk, then milk is masculine. You see, it is a masculine feminine. So masculine feminine, I mean masculine singular, it is a. You see, the suffix here is a and there is e. Okay? Dudh chaida. You don't say dudh chaidi. You see, cha chaidi, because cha is feminine. And dud is masculine, so dud chaida. See, and moreover, if you have this is singular, but if you have a plural, masculine plural, for example, you have, see, you say kapda. You see, kapda means cloth, any cloth. If I say kapda chaida, you see, now it's a very good example. You see. First of all, it is masculine singular, you see, it is masculine and singular. But if it is masculine plural, then it would be kapde and chaide. See, there are suffixes which are meant for masculine singular, and there are suffixes which are masculine plural. Similarly, feminine singular and feminine plural. If it is chai di, it is one, chai diya becomes two, more than one. You see, all for the time being, you don't have to remember all these things. What I want to emphasize is that in Punjabi, there are endings which are masculine singular and there are endings which have plural. Masculine singular generally is a, masculine plural will be a, feminine singular would be e, and feminine plural would be ia. You see, in English, for example, we will say a boy went away, you want to say anything, you see, and a girl also went away. If I add boys and girls, it still will not make any difference. It's a correct English if you say a boy went away, or the boys went away, a girl went away, or the girls went away. It is the grammatically went away, remain, went away. There are some situation like for some is going or are going, there can be. But there again, you'll say, you'll see that there will be another problem. A boy is going, you see, a girl is going, there is no difference. You see, only if you say boys, then instead of is, you will have are. No, we are not teaching the grammar of English here. The idea is that in English it is so. In Punjabi it will be, it is not so. In Punjabi, wherever there is a, you see, there is a coordination between the verb and the subject. If a subject is masculine singular, the verb is also has a suffix which is masculine singular. If a subject is feminine singular, then the verb is also grammatically feminine singular. And similarly, if it's plural, it is plural. See, these are to be remembered very clearly is that these distinctions are made, they will be made as you go along learning the language, and one has to be careful about what is masculine, what is feminine in Punjabi, and what is singular and what is plural, because plural and singular does not simply mean one and more, because especially when it comes to grammar, I mean especially when it comes to verb, because in Punjabi a verb is also either singular or plural, or it is feminine or singular, which of course not the case in most of the language, Germanic languages. English, for example, in some cases they make some little distinction, or he goes, she goes, it will be the same. In Punjab, for example, he goes, you see, and she goes, there is no difference. But in Punjabi, you see, will be po jada hai and oh jandi hai. Now here you will see the difference another. For he and she, it remains always oh. You see, in English you make a distinction between he and she in this case, but in grammar in Punjabi you don't make a distinction. In both cases oh. Oh means oh, whoever it may be she, it may be he. You see, and then there is a distinction between as far as the verb is concerned, one is janda, the other is jandi. Okay? Now, Punjabi would be, you see, oh janda hai, this remains the same, oh jandi hai. I mean, this is just to sort of show how Punjabi is written. I mean, you will slowly learn it, but it will take time. For the time being, it's enough to know that Punjabi is not written in normal Roman script. You see, it has its own script, which script is different from not only Roman script, but it is also different from the script of other Indian languages, because Hindi is written in a different, it is written in Devanagari, whereas Punjabi is written in Gurmukhi, which is a script quite close, it corresponds fairly well to consonants and vowels, but it is not the same, it is distinct. As one naturally in the process of learning the language, you will end up learning those things also. Again, we come back to a little bit of, a few words now, you see, you have a, you see, again, I am taking examples from this book. You see, this first sentence is, A mere dost ne, he is my friend. Just to say, I won't write all the time Punjabi, but sometimes.
see, ye mere dost ne, ye mere dost ne, he is my friend. Now, you, there is one thing grammatical important here is that you can say here, if you say, A mera dost A, you see, it is literally means he is my friend. When I use the term A mere dost ne, literally in English would be they are my friends. But actually we are using for one person. In Punjabi, like sometimes in English, in French also, this is why there are some commonalities. When we use plural for singular, this is to show respect. You see, if this friend is your boyfriend friend or with whom you are very close, then you say mera dost hai, he is my friend. But if you want to present this your friend to somebody and you are presenting respectfully, so the person is singular but the grammar is plural. This is a mere dost ne, he is my. See, both the sentences mean the same thing, but they culturally they are different. Here you are, it is colloquial, it is familiar, this is respectful, this is polite. See, these are so plural. Important thing is the plural is not necessarily means plural in Punjabi. Plural may sometimes mean simply respect. See, as in this case, then he is my friend, and then you say a. See, then we will keep this respectful form. See, then you name the person. You see, and then you have name, and here there will be the name of the person. You see, a Ram Gopal ne, a Hardyal ne, Hardyal Singh ne, a Mirza ne, a Sita ne. See, you can here you substitute the name. This is he. Or even she, as I told, U and A do not necessarily mean he or she. It may be, it depends on who the, if the name, if it refers to girl, this would mean she. If it refers to male, it will mean he. So this is the frame. You have he, but you see the difference. In English you will say he is my friend. This verbal form would be here. He is, you see, is, that is ne or a. You see, a ne would be in this category. And then you mention, he is my friend, he is my friend so and so, you see. Or you say that fellow is my friend, but that will be again a different. You see, if you say he is my friend Ram Gopal, it is means something different, and Ram Gopal is my friend, you know, there are two different kind of sentences. In any case, in Punjabi, or this is true in Hindi also, the verbal form normally comes at the end of the sentence and not in the middle of the sentence. You see, the so you have subject, object, verb. This is the normal pattern, but as you will see, there are so many reasons. Sometimes, if you want to emphasize, you may bring the verb before, or you can say. You see, it depends on how would you say. You can also say a ne mere dost. You see, a ne mere dost Ram Gopal. See what we have done here, that in a way, in sort of a comma, he is my friend Ram Gopal. You see, and here we are again respectful term, so the verb is here. Normally it would be a mere dost Ram Gopal ne. You see, that is the normal term. But if you want to sort of emphasize, you see, this is, if you want to emphasize, then the verbal form would be brought before the object. So there will be subject and then there will be object. This will be dost ne. You can so there are these forms and they are quite, they are very important to, because in spoken English both are very, very important to say. You see, first of all, a mere dost said, you can say mere dost ne. You see, and you can say a ne mere dost. And then after that you say, you can name the person, Ram. You see, a mere dost ne, that is, he is my friend. A ne mere dost, he is my friend. And then you present the person. See? So, you change the slightly the structure of the sentence, and you change, in a way, this is also the way how you change the intonation better. When you say "a mere dost ne," so it is like a very simple going like this. But "a ne mere dost," you see, you emphasize here, and then "a ne mere dost," you see, you emphasize, and then you present the thing. See, this is "a ne." See, this becomes emphatic. You see, "a ne mere dost." You see, and to emphasize something, you first of all raise the pitch on that intonation pattern, and you change also the structure of the sentence. See? So you now this sentence, a ne mere dost. You see, again, and then the other forms of cha chai di. See, and then the third pattern today we will use this we have already discussed. A ne mere dost, cha chai di. You can say cha chai di hai, ya cha chai di hai, depending upon the intonation. It can be a question or an answer. Now the third pattern, which is another pattern, which is a few days ago, 10 days, see, 10 din hoye, 10 days ago. See, something that happened 10 days before. See, then hoye again, thus then is plural, so it is hoye. See, and so thus then hoye, we then hoye, ten then hoye. You can say do then, see, do ten char. You see, the same thing. This is 2, 3, 4. See, that you can have, then this is another structure. First, the you see, 10 days happened, like that, or 10 days ago. But ago, we have done, see, hue is actually verb, it is not ago in that sense. Something happened 10 days ago. So, this is the verb, this is the noun phrase, and this is the verb phrase. This is very important that in English it will not work like that. You see, will be different. So there is a, so I will just now, before concluding or just before concluding, write ek, do, tin, char, panj, che, सत्त, this is just to give a slight idea of how the same thing is written in Punjabi. obviously you won't be able to read this, but doesn't matter. What I am giving is that it looks like something like that, which will do so. And anyway, this is turn. Ek, do, ten. See, important thing here is that this is unaspirated ka, and it is do, it is ten. This is important. It is dental ten. It is not ten. It is not ten. It is ten. Ta, like the French ta. You see, char, not much problem. Panj also, except that it is not cha panj, it is not panj. These cha, pa are not aspirated. So you have to, for the English speakers, it's a very serious problem because they will make it panj or char. See, it is not char, it is cha. So you have to de-aspirate. You have to say it more like the way the French, if you learn French. Che, che is okay because che is anyway, this is what you do. Cha, it is aspirated, so this is no problem. Sat, sat again, this is a problem because this is dental. You see, now this is where serious difference will be. Sat is with dental and no aspiration. At, which is ta and aspirated. So ta is back. Ta, when you, with your tongue, you touch your teeth. That this is why it is called dental. Ta, sat, like tin. You see, whether it is in the beginning or at the end, it is always ta. Tin, sat. At is not only ta in the, is ta, but it is also aspirated, ta. You see, so it is at, no, no, it is a vowel, it's open vowel, it's not no, it is no, it is a vowel which is open, and thus, thus again, is again, it is da, it is not da, because in English, this will be pronounced as das, you see. So, it is again dental da. You see, this is the difference between ta and da is that ta here and here, they are dental and voiceless. And da is dental but voiced, you see. So, there is a, as we say, and technically there is no vibration here. Ta is a stop, da, there is a vibration which is voice. So, it is voiced. So, anyway, ek, do, ten, char, panj, che, sat, at, no, das. So, this is a little bit of vocabulary for you. Some we have introduced today, few new words, 10 words for the first 10 ordinal numbers. Cha, of course, is tea, dud is milk, coffee is coffee. Now, one more important thing in Punjabi is that with the introduction of English, most of the educated Punjabis use quite a few English words while they are speaking. So, if you don't remember some word, and if your grammar is okay, if your subject or verb is at the end of Punjabi, you can easily use English words and it will still be considered Punjabi, but because most of the Punjabis these days, especially educated boys and girls, use a lot of words of English in their normal language. So, which in a way, for the speakers of English, it is an easier affair. If they forget a word, you use your English word. It will be all right. There will be no problem. You see, that is also the thing. And then, of course, we have learned this cha, coffee, dud. These are new words, and some problems of gender, because number and gender in Punjabi is not just 1, 2, 3. It is also grammatical, and it is not only physical gender, masculine and feminine. Every item in Punjabi is either masculine or feminine, and this feminine and masculine, when they are singular and plural, this being singular and plural is also noted in the verb form. The verb is also to accord with the subject. If it is masculine and singular, the verb will also be in masculine and singular. If the verb is masculine plural, then the verb will also be masculine plural. Similarly, if it is feminine singular or feminine plural, the verb will accordingly be in feminine singular or feminine plural. This is one step further than what we had earlier, we will continue in our lessons, and as we, you will see, there will be lot of repetition. So there nothing much to worry. We will repeat again and again, and as a result, you will learn our consonant, our vowel systems, and our grammar. Just before we leave, we just a few words, not an exhaustive explanation of the vowels of Punjabi, because in Punjabi there are 10 vowels. You see, four, and these are four, and this is long E, short E, A, or we can write the other way around, E, U, O, short U, long U, O, open O, A. Now this is to get it better naturally, we will see how it works. We can say you see AE then or deen. You see, there are two different words. Then is day, deen is religion or something. You see, then deen, the long or short vowel makes a difference. If you have a short vowel, it means one thing, then and long. So the vowel can be short or long. Similarly, you can have say short and long. You can have tan, you can have tan. There is a long vowel and short. So a e, there are two different vowels. Similarly, a, there are two different vowels. You can have a, or you can have a. You see, there are different ways. You can have la, or so many other words, many pe, te, ke. You see, a, there are two different ones. You see, la. You can have O and O. You can have Po, you can have Po, or something else. See, Chor, you can have Chor, and you can have Chor. If you, the difference between these vowels make a distinction. They are distinct vowels. Now, it is important to know, because in most of the European languages, these vowels are not distinct from each other, or they are different systems of vowels. You see, so and similarly, you have tor, for example, and tur. You see, you can have or something else. See, tor, tur. The vowel can be short or long. You see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. See, 5 vowels you can have these distinctions. What we will do next time is, we will have a very fairly large number of words with different vowels and with different consonants, and we will practice them, because this is also very important. So what we will do is, every lesson we will have two sections. One will concentrate on how the sentences and words are pronounced with vowels and consonants and tones, and the second would be some every day will introduce some grammatical feature, singular, plural, and slowly, past, present, future, you know, all these normal things. But you must remember that these systems do not function the way they function in English or in any other language. So it is an independent language. It has its independent sound structure, independent grammar structure, just like others. I mean, it's not that this is more independent than the others. Every language has its own grammatical structure and own sound structure. And if you want to learn a language, you must confine yourself on the given structure of the given language. This is how, and we will continue with this. Thank you.